So this journey was very, very stressful. Many people lose their life. From Libya to where the rescue saw us, we have been in the sea for 14 to 15 hours. But thank God we're still alive.
Je suis venu en Libye pour travailler. En Libye, il y a la violation des droits de l'homme. Donc, l'opportunité est là de venir en Italie. C'est pour cela que j'ai pris ce risque de me lancer dans le siècle pour venir en Italie.
Just asking the age and where they're coming from. If they're like under 18, if they're traveling alone, it's for our own database and also for MRCC asking.
Life is just full of risk. She was pregnant, but we have to take the risk. But I know I was scared. I was very, very scared.
It's kind of a difficult mission this time, because we had to look for boats also in the dark. It was very difficult to find them. First people who came on board, there's about 233. They stayed on board for 4 nights. They were already tired. And staying 4 nights on board and with the waves and the wind, it's not very, very nice.
So this gentleman is a 32-year-old male. He'd been on the boat for at least 16 hours. He tells me that he's been unwell for 13 days with a fever and abdominal pain, and he was obviously dehydrated and a bit cold, so we warmed him up and then we're giving him some antibiotics and fluids. We're also giving him some pain medication, and he says he's already feeling better.
Try and to relax his stomach for me.
Vous devez vous relaxer.
He is sicker than average. We don't see too many sick people simply for the fact that you need to be healthy to get that far. And you would never make it to the beach in Libya. If you were really sick, you would die along the way. In the best case scenario, people are only on the boat for 36 hours, so hopefully we manage it and then take them off. Anybody with a life-threatening illness that we cannot manage on the boat, we do have the option of calling for a helicopter if we need to have them taken off.
For the medical team, there's a lot of casualties, a lot of people with fuel burns, and with toothaches, with fever, and they did a tremendous job. It's like they were almost 24/7. They were treating people just to avoid it that would get worse.
So we have to take decision to travel out from our country, because our country nowadays is very, 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 very bad. So we have to take the decision to travel out to look for a better living.
Et je sais que l'Europe aussi c'est un continent qui respecte le droit de l'homme. L'Europe aussi c'est un continent aussi qui fait du bien, non seulement aux personnes vulnérables. Je sais qu'arriver en Europe, ma vie sera en sécurité, aussi je pourrais faire quelque chose pour la famille et aussi pour mes enfants et ma femme.
Just a moment.